Well, Vergil, we made it to your house. We're here in Dallas, Texas. How are you feeling today? I haven't seen you in a while. You look very healthy.
Yeah, I feel great. You know, we've been taking some time off, but we've been back in the gym. I've been running. I just got back from California. I was out there for like a few days, 5 days.
And, so your dad's here, of course, Vergil Senior. You just got a hat.
That's
your city, right?
Yeah, I've been looking for this GP sign forever, and Vergil had it in his closet. They tell me.
So Vergil, real quick, show me what you have in your bedroom. This is your bedroom, right?
I mean, all right. So we got the bed because it's the bedroom. You got the chair that I sit in. I always lay on.
You got a home theater. When they say home theater.
Yeah, I got that. The PS5. You know, I have a record player right there.
I heard you're in a new video game, but it's not out yet.
That's right. Well, the game is out, but I'm not out yet. That makes sense.
Oh yeah.
I have a. This is my music station right here.
What's your favorite? Because there's acoustic, there's electric.
Well, electric is for sure my favorite, but you know, I appreciate the acoustic so much. It's just a different sound. Yeah, my favorite guitar that I have here, I think it's either this one or the one I have under the bed, which is signed by a guy from Mice and Men, Phil Manzon, awesome guitar player. This one right here was signed by Michael from Incubus.
No way.
Awesome guy. Yeah, when we did the, when I was playing along to the guy on the guitar in Reno Del Rey, that was him. Yeah.
You know what? They were in South Park. That's why I think they're cool. Because I didn't know who they were before, but you're in a South Park episode. Eric Cartman's talking about Incubus. That's pretty impressive.
Yeah, he's awesome, man.
Now, you were going live, or you were taking requests for songs, and then you took a break from that.
Yeah.
Why?
I haven't done it in a while. I don't know. I just haven't done it in a while. I get nervous when I play in front of people.
Nah, you got to play for something
play
right
for
now.
In front of hundreds of people, so, you know, it's worse. Like, boxing, that's easy, you know, but...
I think you'll be the first boxer to come up with his own guitar line.
Hey, maybe.
Well, Vergil, you got to play for something. On the guitar or the piano, whatever you prefer.
Okay. I haven't touched this in a while, honestly. Metallica, The Day That Never Comes, badass song off of Death Magnetic. I think it came out in 2005 or something like that.
By the way, I know you almost have no boxing right here in your bedroom. There's no belt, there's no trophy, there's no poster of yourself, there's no picture of yourself. Which, I could go to some of your fans' house and it looks like a Vergil Ortiz museum.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to have pictures of myself in my own room. You know, like, what I have on my walls is like the events on the phone, signed poster I got. The one I had signed personally to me. I have some of my cement memorabilia right there. Some more signed stuff. I got some records right here. Some of them are signed, some of them aren't. But, you know, I feel like my whole life is boxing. So, like, me personally, yeah, I love boxing. Fuck yeah, that's my passion.
You're one of the best fighters in the world.
Well. Yeah, I have other interests as well.
And this is your escape from boxing. Because when you train very hard from morning to night. And one of the reasons I came all the way to Dallas, Texas, because you're the only fighter on the planet, besides your record of 22-28, that has a hedgehog. So yeah, I got to enter. What's his name?
It's Amy.
Amy, she?
It's a girl.
It's a girl. Does she know you?
She does.
She doesn't try to sting you or anything?
What I do. I knock on her thing. Yeah. Like, you know, if you go into someone's house, you got to knock first. So she knows it's me.
Okay. And she knows it's you?
Yeah. And then I just kind of like let her like know it's me.
Vergil, you got a big event this afternoon. I don't know. Can we risk it?
Oh, no, we're good. She's good, man.
She doesn't get mad. She knows your smell and like.
I think she does.
Does she respond to you in any way?
A little bit. I mean.
How long have you had her? It's been a minute.
I've had her for like 2 years, I believe.
Wow, is that a lot?
Yeah, I mean, they have like a lifespan of 5 years.
Okay,
so that's sad. Happened, so in like 3 years, I'm gonna be sad. But damn, I'm.
Could she breed?
She can, but it's kind of illegal to do it unless you're like a. That's like you're an expert because it's...
They're dangerous.
When the mom gets agitated, she'll eat the babies. Yeah. So I don't want her eating her kids, so... Because I'm not going to know how to properly... Yeah, I'm not even here.
So, wait. One time she was on the bed and your dad, by mistake, kneed her.
Yeah. So and... I had her on the bed and I was just like kind of letting her roam outside of her cage just so she could have a different, you know, View or whatever, and I forgot about her. I went to school. I went to my college class, math class, and I just forgot about her under a pillow, I believe. And my brother was here.
No, under the cover, cabrón.
Yeah.
Shaquille's in the house.
Yeah. Hey, Papa. And yeah, so he jumps on my bed. I wasn't here when he did it, but he jumps on my bed, and she gets scared. He gets stabbed like 1,000 times, and yeah, that's what happened.
It wasn't a good experience, huh?
Nah, basically the pillow. My other son was there playing, and I was gonna play a game with him, and so I got the pillow was here, and I got the cover, and I went like this, and then I just jumped on there. And it's the worst sting I've ever felt. And I got up and he got me like...
Was it like a bee sting times 50 or...?
Yeah, but like 60. He got me like 60-something times right here. And
wow.
Like, and I thought that my mom came, because her name's Amy. She was Amy. I'm like, because the thing had blood all over it.
So your mom was worried about the hedgehog? That
it was actually blood for
everyone
me.
Loves the hedgehog.
It was blood for me.
Yeah.
So
wow.
The pins on those
yeah.
are actually hollowed. So when it stabs you, the blood leaks and covers it.
It's
it
makes like a syringe.
Yeah. So and that shit got me good.
But she loves you, Vergil. Look at the calmness. Nah, she doesn't get mad.
I mean, she does live. I do this. She gets mad.
How often do you feed her?
I feel her ball up, man, and she's good. It lasts like about a week.
1 week.
Yeah.
And she's very friendly, obviously.
I mean, she's not. If I'm being honest, she's not. She don't like people. She really doesn't. Friendly at all. She's not.
No. She's not a people person.
She's but, really not.
But why did you decide a hedgehog? I mean, you could have had...
holds her, man.
But she likes that.
Fuck that.
They made a movie about her.
Oh, Sonic.
But is it a lot of work? Would you recommend people to get it?
It's really not. I mean, I was away for like 5 years. And I'm sure my grandma checked up on her. But I made sure her food was full. She had water. And I mean, that's it. You just got to clean your cage, but... That's really it.
But it's been a good experience just at home.
Yeah. They're very independent animals. They're solitary. They're also nocturnal, so she's not awake during the day.
But does she keep you awake? Does she have a thing like
she used to keep me awake, right?
Would they have that thing over there? Or?
Yeah, she has her little wheel, little hamster wheel, and she runs.
That's cool. She stays in shape.
Yeah. They can run at 12 miles an hour for 5 hours straight.
That's better.
12 miles an hour is a 5-minute mile.
That's pretty good, Vergil.
It's pretty good. She's almost faster than me.
So let's talk boxing for a second.
God damn. For how long can she run?
5 hours straight.
She can run 12 miles an hour, 5 hours. No.
It's a fact. It's a fact.
Get out of here.
It's a fact. That's why Sonic the Hedgehog, that's why they named it after Sonic. The Hedgehog.
Is she overweight or that's how they look normally? Like
she's good. Yeah, she's good. There's some that are like extremely overweight. Like
yeah, but not her.
She's just healthy. Yeah.
So Vergil, I asked your dad about some good fights for you, and he said you and Earl would be a mega fight out here. Maybe biggest Texas fight ever.
Yeah.
You and Crawford would be a great fight if it happens. You know, that would be great.
I want that fight too, yeah.
Who else did you mention?
Those Tim Zhu.
Tim Zhu? Oh, how do you think?
Who else do we got?
Lubin?
Lubin's a good one. Those are some.
Erickson the Hammer?
They're all top 10 names in 154. We just want to fight... Everyone, I'm gonna fight everyone.
You're ready. You're ready for any call. You sign you up.
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, it's not up to me though. You know, I'll take anyone. It's really up to them, the promoters,
the business of boxing. So
I say yes to everyone,
and that's very rare. But that's awesome. What about a potential fight you and Canelo? Would you ever want to do that?
I mean. It's not realistic, but why not? I wouldn't care. Like, let's, you know, I respect him. He's one of the best to ever do it. He's arguably one of the best boxers to do it, you know.
Yeah, you sparred him. He's an amazing fighter, an amazing person.
Yeah, yeah. He's, you know, it would be an honor to share with the ring with him.
So in the meantime, you're just getting ready, taking a little, you know, doing stuff. Now, tell us what's going to happen today. You have a special event at your high school?
Yeah, so we're going to the high school. I just came from there, actually. They're having a... So in my city, there's Grand Prairie High School and there's South Grand Prairie High School. And there's a rivalry, obviously. You know, we want to be the best in the city. And every year, there's a GP versus South game. And it happens here. And for us, it's called Beat South. So at the Beat South game... it's very competitive. It's alive, like, you know, it's like you watch a TV show and it's like the town's all there and enjoying the game, you know. It's cool. It's it has that old school vibe.
Yeah, it's a small town thing.
Yeah, small town vibe.
But I understand that it's a football game.
Yeah.
And high school football in Texas is a religion. It's bigger than some pro sports in other states.
It is.
You're going to have thousands and thousands of people there. Is there a marching band, like in the movies, yeah. Friday night lights and all
yeah.
that?
Yeah. What you're seeing is a real deal.
Yeah, so the band is I don't know if they were like number one in the state or what, but they were number one in something, and they're really
good. Would they let you play a song with them?
I'm not that good, man. I mean, you
can play something.
I mean, I can, but not to that level. You know what I mean? But, I mean, why not? I'm always down to learn stuff.
But it's very nice that they remember you and honor you.
Yeah.
You did run track for them, right? Or
track and cross country.
Track and cross country. Right. And yeah. Are you the only professional boxer in the history of the school, Vergil?
In the school? I mean, I can't say in the school, but maybe that's made it that far.
Is there one thing we can see today? Some of the murals? I haven't seen them myself.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Let's go.
How many do you got?
Two of them are dead. Well, no.
One of them's not really mine.
There's three of them that's only you, and then there's one, and you're in another one, which is the Grand Prix one. The other one is the barbecue one.
The barbecue one, and there's one at the chiropractor's place too in Dallas. Remember?
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, okay, there's one there.
But that new one at the barbecue place, man, that one's sick.
Yeah,
it's badass. It's bigger than this room.
Vergil, have you had a chance to see Oscar De La Hoya's Clapback Thursday episode?
I've seen him, yeah.
He's investing time, money, and effort. It looks good.
Yeah, it looks good. You know, it's getting people watching. That's good.
Now, obviously, when I go places and I ask people who's their favorite fighter, your name comes up a lot everywhere. Today on a plane, a guy sitting near me said, my favorite fighter is Vergil and Bam. When Eddie Hearn says he's not a star, how do you respond to that?
I don't care what Eddie says. You know, at one point, he wanted me, so I don't care.
So what does that say?
It's funny. Huh?
What does that say? That if you would have been with him, would he have said you're not a star?
Of course he wouldn't have said that. So, I mean, like I said, I really don't care.
But you know you're popular. You know yourself. You know, like, 22-0, 21 knockouts is not easy to get. If it was that easy, how come other people don't have that
record? Yeah, I mean, exactly. And you know what? Even if I wasn't popular, you know, I honestly do not care. I don't care. It's like you're trying to throw shade, and I'm just like...
It doesn't matter.
I don't care.
But you wouldn't be honored in front of thousands of people.
You know, to each their own. Everyone can have their own opinion, but some opinions are just wrong.
Does he have anybody? Does he have anybody in his roster you would love to fight?
I don't even know who he has. Who does he have? Does he have Majumov? Because that's another name.
Maybe Majumov, but I know. I think he turned down the fight, from my understanding. But I don't know if he did.
I don't know.
And then, what about you and Conor Benn, 154?
That's a good fight.
Do you like the fight?
Vergil hurts that guy on there. He's not even a 154. He's a 47. You wouldn't want to do that fight. If he already got caught with that stuff, and then imagine if he gets caught in the last second again, then your fight gets...
Okay.
You don't want to do that.
Yeah, that position. So. Yeah.
Vergil, what do you think of Devin Haney suing Ryan Garcia for battery? If that was the case, you could have had 22 cases already.
Look, I already know we're going to have everyone's like, oh, they're just hating on him. But, like, who does that? No one in the history of boxing has done that.
That's a first.
You know what I mean? That's definitely a first. And I have nothing nice to say about it, so I'm not going to say anything about it. You know, that's crazy. Now, did Ryan do something wrong? Of course he did. But to sue someone for battery in a professional boxing match where you're both consensual about it and you both earn money off of it, that's just insane to me.
And add you took money because he missed weight. You got paid. You could have fought Barbosa that night and everybody would have been okay with that. But you got paid. You said $1.5 million. That's a lot of money.
Like I said, I don't have anything nice to say. Let it go.
Next.
I just...
Okay. So what are you up to these days when you're not boxing? Did you watch any movies? Do you just practice your music?
Yeah. So I think one of the first things I did was I went to Oklahoma to see Avenged Sevenfold play. I saw them and Evanescence play. And, man, it was dope. I took my brother for the first time. You know, he enjoyed it as well. He likes rock as well. He likes metal too. And he had a great time. He got to meet all of the band. And so a funny story is, so we Ubered there. You know, I didn't drive up there. We Ubered there. And it took like 2 hours to get in, man. And the Uber we had was terrible. Like, he was literally going the wrong way and he wasn't, I don't know. So the concert ends and it's like 2-3 a.m. and we're just hanging out with the guys and like, all right guys, you know, let's get out of here. I'm like, all right, I was already calling my Uber, bro, like 30 minutes, no Uber, no one was taking me. We were like, not only are we in Oklahoma where it's already, there's nothing, but we were like 40 minutes to an hour outside of Tulsa, which is already a
no dead man's
town.
Land.
It's already
there.
Dead.
I've been there. I was the only car in the road for 5 hours.
So I mean, like, so no one took me, and then the band is like, fuck it, come with us. I was like, you know, like, I was hoping that they were going to say it, but yeah, they said, like,
you went on the
just,
tour bus?
Just ride with us. It wasn't a tour bus because they weren't on tour. It was just one show.
Got it.
And no, but it was cool. Me and my brother, we were talking to them, and we got into a fucking big argument about Whataburger and In-N-Out.
They went with In-N-Out.
They're from Long Beach, Orange County. I got my ass kicked in that debate. I couldn't even say nothing. But.
Now you forgot that was it. This, I follow you on Twitter.
Yeah.
At Vergil Ortiz, and you said that Ozzy Osbourne was in your hotel.
Yeah.
Was this the same trip?
He was. This was in California. So okay. I left to California like Saturday, Sunday, Sunday. I left Sunday, and I was at the Burbank Airport Marriott. And I get there, and there's these rock star looking guys, like just long hair. You can tell what they.
And you didn't
like.
Ask them, what are you guys doing here? Like, how's it going?
Well, okay, so after a while, I just started noticing there's a lot of people here. Everyone's wearing an Aussie shirt, and I'm like, there's no way, right? There's no way he's here right now. And so I'm just walking around, and I have my guitar too, because I take my guitar in California everywhere I go just to practice. And people are looking at me too, like, what does he do? You know, and. So I just gave in, like, who is he here? Like, is Ozzy here? Like, yeah, Ozzy's here. I'm just like, fuck. So I had to go to Target. I ran to Target real quick, and then I came back. I was gone for, like, 15 minutes. Line's gone. And he's already, like, leaving. And I'm just like, fuck. So I didn't get to meet him. But, yeah, Ozzy Osbourne, I love his music. My favorite guitarist of all time, Randy Rhoads, he played with Ozzy before he died. I think it was, like, 25 when he died. You know, sad. But fucking amazing guitarist.
Is it true he bit the head off a bat?
Off a bat, yeah.
Why did he do that?
Clout. I don't know.
Black Sabbath.
He's crazy, man. He's crazy. He's a
but when
crazy
he talks, dude. He sounds like a nutty professor. Like, you know, you know what I mean? Like, very soft. You know?
Yeah. Yeah, man. So that's that. Yeah, I had a good time up there in Burbank, LA area, and that's what I've been doing.
And you're ready to get back in the gym and just do what you do. And
yeah, man. I mean, I feel like I've had enough time off. You know, I've been running. We went to the gym a few times already, and I'm just ready to get back. I just want to see what's next. You know, I don't like to be still too long.
Okay, did you see the fight between Bivol and Bitterbite?
I was so. When did they fight? Was it Sunday or
Saturday?
So when they were fighting, I left Saturday then.
And they fought a little earlier because
I was like boarding the plane when they were fighting, so I didn't actually get to see it.
I'm Ellie Seckback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.